Hey everyone! For today's video, we'll be taking a look at an all-in-one liquid CPU cooler that is positioned at the high end, the ASUS ROG RYUO III 360 ARGB. Now, with the multitude of new processor releases in the past few months at the high end, especially power-hungry offerings such as the Intel Core i9-13900K or AMD's range-topping Ryzen 9 7950X, it would appear that having a good CPU cooler, especially a liquid cooler at that, is a prerequisite to ensure that you can get maximum performance out of your high-end CPU. Let's get started. First things first, the packaging. This being a product from the Republic of Gamers lineup, the box has the usual red and black colorway that has come to be associated with the ROG brand. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this CPU cooler. We'll run through these specs in depth later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the AOK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Opening up the box. As you can see, we get a ROG VIP card of some sort. And here we have it, the RYUO III 360 ARGB. We'll set it aside for the moment to see what accessories ASUS has included with it. First up, we get three 120mm ASUS ARGB fans. We also get a quick start guide right here. And this is accompanied by a sheet of ROG stickers. Apart from these, we also get bags of accessories and fittings right here for the various sockets that this CPU cooler supports. Let's take a closer look at the fans that ASUS has included with the AIO. As you can see, they are ROG AF12S ARGB parts that sport a 7-bladed design with a black frame and translucent fan blades. Now these are 2200 RPM fans that come with a 4-pin PWM connector right here, as well as an ARGB header. The fans also sport rubber dampeners on all four corners of the fan frame, which should go a long way in reducing noise output. Moving on to accessories, we see that the RYUO III 360 ARGB comes with support for an extensive range of processor platforms, from the latest AMD Ryzen 7000 series of processors on the AM5 platform to Intel's LGA 1700 socket for its 13th generation Raptor Lake offerings, to even the venerable LGA 1156 platform, which was used for Intel's first generation Core processors from 13 years ago. Mounting accessories aside, ASUS has included a 3-way PWM fan splitter cable right here. In addition, we do also get a 4-way addressable RGB cable that allows you to hook up the ARGB LEDs of this AIO directly to an addressable RGB header on your PC's motherboard. Onto the radiator and pump of the RYUO III 360 ARGB. The radiator is a 360mm affair that is made of aluminium, and the frame of the radiator has a smooth matte finish. The tubes are sleeved and made of rubber with a length of 400mm according to ASUS. As a sign of the brand's attention to detail, I really like these protective covers that come included for the fins of the radiator, as radiator fins are really delicate and easy to damage during shipping, and I've come across my fair share of bent fins on AIO radiators right out of the box, so this is a nice touch for sure. For flexibility with installation, the tubes connect to the pump by means of two adjustable fittings right here. The pump itself has an aluminium housing that feels pretty well built, with an anime matrix LED display that allows end users to display vital system stats or even custom animations. More on this later on in this video. Now the RYUO III also utilizes Asetek's latest 8th generation pump with a 3-phase motor, and moving to its underside, it has a copper thermal transfer plate that comes pre-applied with thermal paste. Do pardon the state of the thermal paste, as this bit of footage was shot after I had done some test runs with the AIO. With that, let's do a quick test of the cooling prowess for this AIO CPU cooler. I have the AIO all set up on a test bench that is powered by the range-topping Intel Core i9-13900K, which, in case you're unaware, is a power-hungry beast of a CPU with a power draw of more than 300 watts when power limits are removed. If you're interested to find out more about the details of this test bench and how it performs from a gaming and productivity standpoint, go check out the other video that I did. The link to the video is provided up top. For this video, we'll be focused more on the thermal performance of the Ryuo 3, where I'll be measuring the temperature of the 13900K while it's running Cinebench R23's multi-core test. I'll also be monitoring the CPU package temperature while playing the single-player mode of Cyberpunk 2077 and Far Cry 6. Do note that during these three tests, the power limit settings were left to the default auto settings, which lets the BIOS optimize the power limits according to the CPU load. Finally, to push the Ryuo 3 to its limits, I'll remove the power limits entirely for the 13900K and run the Cinebench R23 multi-core test again to see what kinds of thermal results we'll be getting. Let's get started. First up, we've got Cinebench R23's multi-core test, where after checking Hardware Info 64's logs over the entirety of the test, the 13900K achieved an average CPU package temperature reading of 89 degrees Celsius, with a low of 60 degrees Celsius and a high of 92 degrees Celsius. With the thermal headroom afforded by the Ryuo 3, the system achieved a good multi-core score of 39,169, with subsequent test runs being in the high 38,000s and low 39,000s as well. In terms of clock behavior during the test run, as you can see, the 13900K achieves an average P-core frequency of around 5.4 GHz and an E-core frequency of close to 4.3 GHz. Moving on to actual gameplay tests, while playing the single-player campaign mode of Cyberpunk 2077 on the Ultra Graphics preset, Cycle Ray Tracing, and DLSS as well as FSR disabled at the 1440p resolution, the 13900K achieved an average CPU package temperature of around 62.1 degrees Celsius, a low of 53 degrees Celsius, and a high of 68 degrees Celsius. Onto the single-player campaign of Far Cry 6, with the maximum possible graphics preset with FSR disabled at the 1440p resolution, the Core i9-13900K achieved an average CPU package temperature of around 59.6 degrees Celsius, a low of 56 degrees Celsius, and a high of 64 degrees Celsius with the Ryuo 3 360 ARGB. With that, let's remove the power limits on the 13900K entirely and see what kind of a thermal outcome we're gonna get with the Ryuo 3 360 ARGB while running the multi-core test of Cinebench R23. Unsurprisingly, the 13900K really puts the AIO CPU cooler to the test, with an average CPU package temperature of 94.2 degrees Celsius, a low of 61 degrees Celsius, and a high of 99 degrees Celsius. During the test, you can see that the 13900K drew over 300 watts of power at times, and the system successfully completed the test runs while putting out higher multi-core scores than with the power limits in place, with scores as high as 39,578. And with that, here's a summary of the thermal performance of the ROG Ryuo 3 360 ARGB AIO CPU cooler. In terms of idle temperatures, the 13900K achieved an average CPU package temperature reading of around 38.2 degrees Celsius, with a low of 36 degrees Celsius and a high of 43 degrees Celsius. A short mention about acoustics and fan noise. While I didn't have a proper decibel meter with me to measure the noise from the fans, I used a noise meter app on my smartphone instead, where I positioned the phone 30 centimeters away from the fans of the AIO CPU cooler. I got a reading of 58 decibels when the fans increased in speed on the default fan curve, while the CPU was under heavy load running Cinebench R23's multi-core test. I also got a reading of 54 decibels when the PC was running Cyberpunk 2077 or Far Cry 6. For context, the baseline ambient noise of my surroundings was measured to be around 53 decibels, meaning to say, under normal gaming loads, I couldn't really hear the fans at all given the ambient noise of my surroundings. Do note that these readings were obtained on the stock power limit settings for the 13900K. On to the Anime Matrix LED display of the Ryo 3. As mentioned earlier, you can configure the LED display to show vital system statistics, preset animations, or even custom animations to jazz up the appearance of your PC build. All this can be configured via the Armory Create app, where selecting on the Ryo 3 under the list of devices, you have the ability to select from a range of preset animations like so. Or alternatively, to display vital system statistics such as CPU frequency, GPU frequency, and so on. You do also get the ability to create your own custom animation from scratch, where I did find the process of creating my own graphic and animation a bit of a finicky process. Do note that when installing the AIO, you've got to have the pump oriented such that the pipes are in this position. Otherwise, you may face issues with getting the animations and graphics oriented in the right position, where I found the Armory Create app cumbersome to use for this purpose. All in all, the ROG Ryuo 3 360 ARGB is a beefy and premium AIO liquid CPU cooler that works pretty well with high-end CPUs such as the 13900K, where it allowed the 13900K to achieve its performance potential. If you're keen to delve deeper into the synthetic and gaming performance of this exact same setup, go check out the other feature video that I did some weeks back. No doubt, we saw toasty temperatures earlier on in this video during the Cinebench R23 tests, especially when power limits were removed, but this is expected thermal behavior from modern CPUs such as the 13900K that are designed to run at such high temperatures, where the Ryuo 3 was successful in cooling over 300 watts worth of heat output from the 13900K to produce pretty good Cinebench R23 multi-core scores. Some downsides worth mentioning. I found the experience of setting up custom graphics and animations for the Anime Matrix LED a little challenging via the Armory Create app, and the fact that this AIO CPU cooler is pretty pricey. As of end December 2022, the ROG Ryuo 3 360 ARGB can be had for around SGD 469 through offline and online retailers in Singapore, which converts to roughly $346 for you international folks. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.